One fundamental principle within technology and indeed within information security is the principle of least privilege. So when we're talking about who has access to what and who has access to do what, how do we make sure that they only have access to the things they need in order to do their job? This is not about trying to put unnecessary controls around people's rights or freedoms or anything like that. It's about trying to minimize risk. Compartmentalize it. If someone doesn't need access to a system and we don't give it to them, then their interactions with that system can't happen in an insecure way. They just simply don't happen. So when we talk about shadow IT, one of the things we want to think about is that when people do use systems which may traditionally have fallen outside the boundaries of traditional IT, is it people who actually need it? Can we provision these services in a way that we only give them to the people that need them in order to perform their duties? This is the heart of the principle of least privilege. And this is relevant whether we're talking about internal formal systems or external systems which may otherwise fall into the realm of shadow IT. Another way of thinking about this is imagine if everyone in a team or in a department only had access to just the tools that they needed to do their job. There's a whole bunch of things the salespeople need access to that the finance people don't. The marketing people need something different again. Us as technology people need something different again. How do we minimize the risk by reducing what people have access to? And again, this isn't necessarily about trust. It's not saying, look, I don't trust those people in the sales department. This is to make sure that regardless of how trustworthy the salespeople are, they simply are not even given the potential for things to go wrong. Now, put back in the context of shadow IT, particularly as we start to use more systems outside the traditional boundaries of the organization, we do increase that footprint of risk. So this is the mitigation. Like, let's use these systems. There's value to using these systems. But let's do it in a way that brings that risk level down. With the security model built this way, with the principle of least privilege, shadow IT becomes a lot less scary because the applications that do fall into that shadow IT realm pose a lot less risk to the organization because there's less people using it. There's less access to data. That makes a lot of sense. Lastly, let's talk about culture because we are talking about humans here, and humans do have a very important role to play in the security culture of an organization. Now, here's a really simple way to think about shadow IT. It's only shadow IT if you don't know about it. If you do know about it, and you're part of the solution, you, of course, being the IT people, but if you become part of the process as the IT department, if you encourage people in the business to come to you and request access to these services, it ceases to become shadow IT. It is now a formal part of the organization's process of onboarding new applications and services. Now, to be clear, this is not advocating that whatever the business wants, they get. There are certainly cases out there where services just simply don't make sense for an organization because of things like the security risk. But I would much rather IT departments be part of that discussion. And that's a conclusion that they reach in conjunction with the business, then the business working in a culture where people are just going to go out and do it anyway and not have any engagement with the IT department. Conversely, you may well decide that there are cases where it makes sense to allow some apps, which perhaps are not ideal. But particularly in these strange times, sometimes it makes sense to proceed forward with at least knowledge of the services that are being used, even if it's not the way that we would do things had we a little bit more time and resources. The same 1Password survey I mentioned earlier found that when knowledge workers break the IT rules, 49% of the time, they're just trying to get their job done. It doesn't mean that they're out there being malicious or trying to do the wrong thing. They're just trying to be effective in their role in the organization. Now, this all comes back to what I mentioned at the start of this video, where I said, look, sometimes you need to give up a little bit of control to get more control. Give up a little bit of control over everything going through the same formal processes in order to get a little bit more control over this whole shadow IT thing. And lastly, recognize that shadow IT is a thing, usually because people are just trying to get their job done. They're not out there trying to do the wrong thing. And you might find that this is actually a reflection of a blind spot within the organization's own IT capabilities. Someone's gone out there and used that cloud service in order to fulfill a task because they couldn't find something within the organization to do it the formal way. That's a really important lesson for us as technology people to take on board as well. Are we providing the right tools? Or is shadow IT solving a problem which we are partially responsible for? So let's wrap up the shadow IT piece, and I'm going to begin with a really simple concept. If you want people to obey the rules, have as few rules as possible. At the very least, when it comes to shadow IT, invite people to talk about those rules. Hey, you want to use applications that we don't already provide as a formal part of the organization's offerings? Tell us about it. What's the problem you're trying to solve? I always found back in the day, when I was in the IT department, literally just saying to people, what problem are you trying to solve by using this tool, by using the Access database I mentioned earlier on? Now, when I asked that question and I understood what the challenge my colleagues in the business were facing, I was often able to help them solve the problem by more formal means. This requires dialogue, right? It requires a conversation with the business users. We need to try and think of ourselves in technology capacities as enablers of business. So how do we help business run? What can we do to make it more efficient, more effective? That's a really critical question for us to ask, and it strikes at the heart of the problem which leads to shadow IT. The best way to control shadow IT may not be to try and fight it, but rather to bring it out of the shadows, into the light, and do your best to accommodate it. If you've enjoyed this video as part of the Hello CISO series, then please give it a like and subscribe to the 1Password YouTube channel for more videos like this.